Good morning. I'm going to present the keynote titled Distribution System Evolution and the Use of Internet of Things-Based Decentralized Architectures. In this presentation, after briefly introducing DMA response and its role in a smart grid, I will talk about the motivations behind the use of Internet of Things-based decentralized architectures that are mainly related to the distribution systems evolution to local energy markets and the advent of aggregators. I will then present a transactive management infrastructure for a virtual power plant aggregator that we have designed and developed at the University of Salerno. I will describe then a mixed integral linear programming optimization model for assessing the participation of distributed residential photovoltaic battery systems in the ancillary services market that has been considered for an Italian pilot project. Finally, I will present some findings and conclusions. As known, the aim of a DMA response is to make the load an active participant in balancing electricity supply and demand around the clock via side-by-side competition with supply-side resources. DMA response is based on changes in electrical use by customers from their normal consumption patterns in response to changes in the price of electricity over time or to incentive payments designed to induce lower electricity use at times of high wholesale market prices or when system reliability is at risk. This may happen by using direct control by the utility or by participating in the ancillary services market, as I will show later. The National Institute of Standards and Technology Smart Grid Interoperability Standards Interim Roadmap proposes a conceptual model for the smart grids where for each type of user, residential, building, commercial, industrial, the boundaries of the consumer domain are typically considered to be the utility smart meter and the home gateway. Customers can participate to DMA response programs directly with the utility or through an intermediary. In the organized markets, the end user customers are generally aggregated by intermediaries known as aggregators. They present to the organized market the end user customers' aggregated capability and possess all the technology required to perform DMA response, and moreover, they are responsible for the installation and communication and control devices for the user. Aggregators also generally write contracts with users who are offered lower energy costs or incentives in exchange for occasional load shedding or control of their storage systems, as we will show, for example, for a pilot project in Italy. There is an example where the aggregator sends price or event messages to all houses over a home area network. These signals enter the house to a home gateway. Then an energy management system represents the entry point for all applications such as remote load control, in-home display of customer usage, reading of non-energy meters, monitoring and control of distributed generation, and also integration with building management systems and their enterprise. Now I will discuss the motivation of new Internet of Things-based decentralized architectures. These are mainly due to the evolution of the distribution systems, to the advent of local energy markets, of new figures such as the aggregators, and to the spreading of DMA response programs. Most of the information I will present can be found in these two papers, if you are interested to more details. As known, future electricity distribution grids will host a considerable share of the distributed renewable energy sources, and the electrical power system is undergoing a rapid transition toward decarbonization and decentralization. In particular, residential and commercial utility customers that were once simply consumers of electricity are deploying distributed energy resources, becoming producers themselves in a new, increasingly decentralized power system. So, the flexibility offered by these new resources and technologies can reduce the electricity and infrastructure costs while enabling the power sector to meet decarbonization targets. In particular, two distinct visions exist to operate this system with the high penetration of renewable energy sources. One vision is based on a centralized full system optimization performed by the transmission system operator. The other vision involves a decentralized, layered decomposition optimization structure, as shown here in this figure of the system, where at a given layer of the system, the optimization only requires visibility of the interface points with the next layers above and below. Some issues related to the centralized paradigm are its technical complexity, scalability, and the trial bypass. Traditional markets, in fact, lack the ability to respond in real time to high variation of volatile renewable energy sources. The layered paradigm is instead preferable and can facilitate the successful evolution of the electric system with the high penetration of renewable energy sources. In a layered paradigm, the distribution system operator or an aggregator, as shown here, would aggregate all renewable energy sources or distributed energy resources within each local energy market. Local energy markets represents, in fact, a solution to enable the real-time management of the uncertainties introduced by renewable energy sources by exploiting the flexibility of elastic loads generation of electricity storage technologies. In a layered optimization paradigm, instead of numerous distributed energy resources and their aggregations bidding directly into the wholesale market and scheduled and dispatched by the independent system operator, the distribution system operator aggregates all distributed energy resources within each local distribution area. In this paradigm, the distribution system operator provides a single bid to the wholesale market at the transmission distribution interface. When the independent system operator clears the market bid of the distribution system operator, then it takes the responsibility to preserve real-time supply-demand balance within each local energy market, relying on internal distributed energy resources, as well as to the interchange with the transmission system or the wholesale market. The most common approach used to implement a local energy market in medium and low voltage distribution networks, typically managed by a virtual power plant aggregator, is that of using methods as optimal power flow that are usually applied to determine the dispatch schedules for each of the trading periods in the wholesale market and to calculate distribution locational marginal prices, since these prices take into account the physical limitations of the network, are based on local grid needs as well as participant supply and demand, help to evaluate possible distribution network congestions and power losses. Being time and location specific, they offer potential real-time prices to expose to participants. Now the question is, how Can we design real-time pricing based on the distribution location and marginal prices? Control theory for large complex systems tell us that there are certain situations where markets which rely on economic signals to entities that may voluntarily respond are not sufficiently effective to maintain reliable system operation. This is mainly due to the speed of the required response or to the signal refresh cycle and to the number of entities that receive and must react to the signal. Such situations are better managed via controls. In fact, markets should be therefore based on predictable and consistent control signal, mainly based on a safe response. Thus, we arrive to the transactive energy concept and do transactive controllers that can react in real time and autonomously to economic signals. In this context, there are many definitions for transactive energy. We can say that transactive energy allows users to become prosumers. That means both producers and consumers of energy, empowering them to transact by making bids based on real-time local prices with each other, as well as with the utility to maximize profit while helping to balance the grid. In a previous research, we developed an approach introducing nodal prices at the distribution level in a distribution energy market, such as that of a microgrid. Distribution location and marginal prices are based on three cost components: energy costs, congestions, and power losses costs. Transactive controllers have been designed to control air conditioning units and some shiftable loads and to make bids on the distribution electricity market in response to distribution location and marginal prices and according to end user requirements. More details can be found in this paper. On the basis of these researches and considering the previously discussed concept related to the layered distributed paradigm, local energy markets, distribution location and marginal prices and aggregators, in the last year we have developed in collaboration with an Italian company an Internet of Things based architecture for demand response, in which each residential unit is connected to a gateway and controlled to an energy management system that has been implemented on a Raspberry Pi 3 microcontroller and is in communication with the aggregator by means of an interconnection layer consisting of a cloud-based server, a manager gateway, and a database. A centralized database, in fact, registers the electrical energy consumption of all the electrical loads and the generation of the photovoltaic systems of the users. Optimization and management tools have been implemented by using Blockly Visual Programming Editor for creating rules and are employed to assist the aggregator in carrying out third-party services for energy saving and smart metering. The aggregator also arranges financial tariffs for its customers and determines the bid for electrical energy into the electricity market. As you can see, the energy management system is in wireless connection with some smart devices such as smart metering, smart plug for security systems, smart appliances, photovoltaic system, and telemedicine also. In particular, we have chosen these devices, these smart devices, as shown here. They are all commercial devices that have been included in the system, but also other devices may be connected by developing the required software. Here there is an example of an implementation of energy saving rules implemented by using Blockly Visual Programming Editor, for example, for the control of a boiler by using a smart thermostat and a smart wall switch. Both of them are connected by means of Z-Wave communication to the energy management system. Here you can see the implemented rules by using Blockly Visual Programming Editor. Another example is that controlling a smart lamp in connection with a light sensor. And there are some rules for energy savings. Other rules can be implemented for a security system with a sensor and a siren. Also a control scheme and rules with two Zeta Wave connected smart meters and a smart plug has been implemented for maximizing the energy exploitation from a photovoltaic system in those with energy storage and for smart metering. The motivation and the motivation behind the new developed architecture that we have implementing starting from this Internet of Things architectures are mainly due to many factors that I will describe later. The evolution of the Internet of Things architecture to a transactive management infrastructure for a virtual power plant aggregator is described in this paper, and the motivation behind the development the infrastructure added in a local energy market managed by a virtual power plant aggregator. Prosumers and consumers can trade energy and flexibility within the energy community in a peer-to-peer way. Peer-to-peer may refer to both the way according to which energy transactions take place and to the information architecture supporting them. Blockchain enables peer-to-peer transactions in a decentralized way, perfectly fitting with the idea of making energy transactions without the need of a central authority. Also, blockchain can offer a platform to host transactive energy markets where consumers can directly buy and sell energy with each other. The decentralized control essential for transactive energy is analogous to the decentralized consensus of blockchain, and both share the target of opening and democratizing markets. The main advantages of a decentralized architecture over a centralized one are in terms of scalability, resiliency, adaptability, fault tolerance, security, trust. In this slide, we can see the implemented transactive management infrastructure to enable peer-to-peer transactive energy exchanges. This infrastructure has been implemented to be used by medium-sized aggregators to manage local energy markets. This solution is neither fully centralized or decentralized, but it is organized into layers that interact only with the neighboring layers above and below. In particular, it consists of three layers: the data center owned by a central actor, an aggregator, or a distribution system operator can be thought as a virtualized set of servers which are centrally managed by some central actor. Then we have the communication layer consisting of all components needed to let the transactive controllers communicate to one another. This will contain also the internet cloud part, which rules the access to of the transactive controllers to the demand response transactive energy program, and the user layer, where the transactive controllers execute the demand response algorithms and perform all the communication over the infrastructure. Every participant to the local energy market uses a home energy manager, which is a hardware component, a microcomputer such as a Raspberry platform, and is endowed with a smart meter installed inside the building or house. The purpose of the home energy manager is to let the user access the transactive management platform in order to act as a transactive agent within the local energy market. The home energy manager consists of three main parts: a home device gateway, a transactive controller, and an energy management system. The home device gateway is an interface for communication to the smart devices deployed within the household building. The transactive controller is the software engine needed to make decisions about the energy trading operations. The energy management system coordinates all the communication between the transactive controller and the home device gateway towards the transactive management platform. Now I describe an example of application of the transactive management platform for managing the interaction between a virtual power plant aggregator and its aggregated prosumers. This work was a result of the fruitful collaboration with Professor Dell'Abbadi. A nonlinear stochastic method based on a mixed integer linear programming optimization model has been developed to allow an aggregator to optimally manage a virtual energy storage system consisting of a high number of photovoltaic battery systems for participating in the ancillary services market by considering the provision of both up and down regulation by the aggregator. In particular, the Italian Regulatory Authority for Energy Networks and Environment implemented a new regulation that allowed aggregated distributed energy resources to participate in the market for the ancillary services. This opportunity, given by the recent resolution of the Italian Regulatory Authority, allows an aggregate to be composed of different types of resources, such as generators, loads, battery energy storage system, electric vehicles, without any limit to the rated power of a single resource. But the aggregate must have an overall minimum regulating power that now is 1 megawatt, but in the future will be also lower. The method, the optimization method, allows the aggregator at first to evaluate the baseline of the aggregate by minimizing the costs related to the electrical energy absorbed from the grid, and then to assess the up and down flexibility curves with the relative offer prices. The method considers the contractual constraints and the technical constraints related to the electrical equipment of all the prosumers and the technical constraints provided by the Italian regulation. It can optimize the control of a high number of photovoltaic battery systems while respecting the battery's constraints in order to achieve different objectives. The objective function includes the minimization of the costs related to the electrical energy absorbed from the grid and the maximization of the incentive received by the transmission system operator for the provision of the up and down regulation in compliance with the times and the methods provided by the regulation and considering a forecast of the prices of the accepted offers in the ancillary services market. The expected overall power program of the prosumers included within the virtual energy storage system constitutes its baseline that must be communicated the day ahead. The baseline of the aggregate of users is defined as the sum of the power profiles of the prosumers, calculated considering that their batteries are dedicated to maximize the self-consumption of the energy generated by the photovoltaic system or to minimize the cost related to the electrical energy absorbed from the grid. In particular, we considered a real case with where the system consists of 2,000 residential users, all of them endowed with a controllable photovoltaic battery system and proprietary sized by each user according to its contractual power and energy consumption. The most important software application to manage all the batteries over the virtual energy storage system is the proposed management system platform. It allows to assess the aggregation of the absorbed injected active power our presumers and to evaluate and communicate the data related to the baseline and to the energy flexibility offers for participation in the ancillary services market. The management system platform also receives and implements the dispatching orders sent from the transmission system operator, stores related information and offers monitoring and reporting services for performance validation. In this figure, we can observe the state of charge performance for a day in April for the full system, full aggregate system in a day in April for up regulation. In the lower part of the figure, the average power in a quarter of an hour related to photovoltaic generation to the absorbed power for the baseline and to the absorbed power for up regulation are shown. In particular, as we can see here, the up regulation is delivered for four consecutive hours from 2 p.m. to 6 p.m. And analyzing the results presented in these figures, where we can see the mean of the daily object function of the virtual energy storage system during the year in different months during the year, it is clear and also the mean of the daily remuneration in the case of up regulation and up and down regulation during the year, it is clear that from February to October, the participation of the virtual energy storage system, both in the up and down regulation and up regulation, allows obtaining a daily remuneration that is higher than the daily cost related to the purchase of electricity from the network, making the objective function positive. Also, analyzing the results in this figure, when we can see the mean of the daily increment of the energy costs for the users of the virtual energy storage system with up and down and with up and down regulation during the year, it is clear that in the case of up regulation, in the months from February to October, the costs related to the energy absorbed by the electricity grid are the same as in the case without regulation. In the case of up-down regulation, on the other hand, there is a modest increase in the costs for the entire aggregate in the months from March to October. Now, let's move on to the final comments. I'd like to highlight that peer-to-peer energy transactions based on distributed ledger technology and transactive controllers in local energy markets represents the most likely evolution for future smart grids, as confirmed by recent pilot projects. A new designed and implemented transactive management infrastructure is proposed and described that can represent a baseline for a reference framework for blockchain-based transactive management based on smart contracts that can be used to manage local energy market. Even if peer-to-peer-based solutions can exhibit better scalability than centralized one, studies and real tests should be carried out to evaluate the scalability of a blockchain-based architecture when the number of prosumers significantly increases and the new methods for improving scalability should be identified. Different options for managing the interaction and mutual effects between the local energy markets and the wholesale market should be investigated, while new rules are necessary to regulate the interaction between the distribution systems operator and the transmission system operator. It has been proved that in addition to mitigating the concerns due to non-programmability or renewable energy sources-based generation, storage systems can also be used to provide balancing resources and available energy reserve for the transmission operator, in particular also small battery energy battery systems. As demonstrated by simulation results carried out considering some realistic case studies related to the Italian ancillary services market, the developed optimization method for an aggregator allows to assess the economic impacts of the participation to the ancillary services on the aggregator and on the prosumers. The provision of balancing resources has in fact a modest impact on the self-consumption from the photovoltaic generation. Also, as demonstrated from simulation results, the increase in the use of the batteries due to the regulation provision is negligible. Accordingly, the impact on the prosumers of their participation to the aggregate for the provision of balancing resources in the balancing market is relatively low, so that it can be considered acceptable for the prosumers. Prosumers may in fact benefit from lower energy costs thanks to a portion of the remuneration that they can agree to share with the aggregator. We are now working on a new decentralized and parallel optimization, according to which each prosumer performs an optimization based on its specific objective function and on the results of optimizations performed by other prosumers. In this way, a global solution can be found without any prosumer knowing the behavior or objectives of any other customers. Here there is a list of for further selected readings on this topic. Thank you very much for your attention. If anyone like more information or has questions, please feel free to contact me by email. Thank you very much.